so many Jets fans looked at you as the culture changer, that you were going to go into the locker room and tell everybody this is the way it needs to be done. You're the alpha. Right. You're the dog. Right. You're the guy that's going to go in there and change it. And it seemed like the culture was unchangeable to the point where you're even hearing members of the media tell Trevor Lawrence, if the Jets choose you, you shouldn't come. Would you? I know I'm going to put you on the spot here, but you're used to it.
Yeah.
Would you counsel Trevor Lawrence not to go to the Jets if they draft him, Jamal?
Well, you know, somebody asked me this not too long ago when it did come out.
Right.
I would say this. First off, if you're the number one pick, you have to take it. So it's just not – it wouldn't be smart for him to not, you know, go as the number one pick. That's how I would look at it. Yeah, it's going to be a tough situation. But, you know, I don't know, man. I don't want to say that it can't be turned around, but it has to be a lot of changes from top to bottom, and that's just what it is, man. They have a great fan base, even though they kill me on anything I do that's not, you know, up to par. But it is what it is, man. I talked to Beacham last night. Obviously, he plays with Arizona now, and one of my favorite teammates I ever played with, OG in the game. And, you know, just hearing guys that were a part of that organization while I was there, just saying how proud they are of me, of just sticking to my worth and speaking up and, you know, believing in myself. And I am proud of myself, and I'll always be proud of myself. You know, a lot of people didn't think a 24-year-old would bet on his career and move somewhere else and take on a challenge. And I go through a challenge each and every day. And I understand that, you know, I was the guy over there. I once was the guy, because now I'm nobody to them right now, right? So, but it's still all love and respect. At the end of the day, I understand that fans are hurt with the Jets, and I get that. But I had to do what was best for myself and my family.
And I'll be honest with you, Jamal. I mean, not many safeties net what you netted the Jets in return. I mean, that's a testament to your talent in itself. And so you do wish them all the best. Just not week 14, that's for sure.
I mean, no, definitely not.
What does that calendar look like? Do you have a calendar with a date actually circled, Jamal, somewhere? Does that exist somewhere?
Hey, listen. I cannot wait for that game. That game's going to be wild. It's going to be special. But I tell you what, I'm not going to make it bigger than what it is.
Right.
I know that the media is going to try to, jab at me in every way, in every angle. So I'm looking forward to it, man. I'm really not worried about, you know, what everybody's saying, the PFF ratings and all of this and that. Man, I just want to do whatever I can, you know, whatever I can to help this team win and, just continue to get better, continue to learn the defense. And I'll be fine, man. These guys have my back over here, and I appreciate them more than they know. You know what I mean? And I have a great circle of brothers back home, a great family, great parents, brothers and sisters, nieces, nephews, that support me. And that's all I really need. I'm not out here to try to prove anybody wrong. I'm always trying to prove myself right. You know what I mean? So that's what I'm about, man.
Hey, you watched all the way to the end. Thanks for that. Watch more right here.